Okay, so this lab is pretty brief. It's just covering the basic anatomical terms and positionings. So, whenever we talk about anything dealing with the human body, we reference something called the standard anatomical position. And there's six basic units that compose the standard anatomical position, and it is as follows. Body is upright. It's facing forward. The arms and legs are straight. Palms are also facing forward. Your feet are flat on the ground, and the eyes are open. And so, whenever you're talking about this, you're always referencing the patient or the other individual. It's never from yourself, it's always from their standard frame of reference. And as you kind of get along in this course, what you're going to see is different terminology. Often, it's going to be in Greek or Latin. But it's not too difficult if we kind of break down the basic root of what it means. And so we start right now with table 2.1 on page 14 in your lab manual. And it's really just listing a handful of terminologies that kind of refer to the directions of the human anatomy or the body. Right? And so if we just start from the top, for example, ventral just means towards the front or the belly. Dorsal, like a dorsal fin, is towards the back. Anterior is towards the front again. Posterior towards the back. You'll actually see those often interchangeably. Ventral and dorsal, really a little bit less, but you still do see them. All right, superior means above. Inferior is below. Medial towards the middle. Lateral is out towards the sides, like a lateral pass. Proximal is going to be closer to the point of attachment, right? So we're referencing your trunk in this case. So the trunk is really where your spine is really where most things come to hang on. And so the closer that those things come to that attachment point, the more proximal they'll be. Right? And so distal, kind of same root as distance, it means farther away. Superficial, closer to the body surface, like the Kardashians are very superficial. And then deep, something's very meaningful, it's deep, it's going to be closer to the core or to the insides. Okay, so another couple terms that you need to be familiar with as we move on are anatomical planes. There are three general categories: sagittal, which references left and right, frontal, also called coronal. Coronal comes the root of crown, and so you can imagine a crown being put on somebody's head, and that the front of that crown divides the body into anterior or posterior portions or ventral or dorsal portions. And then transverse divides the body into superior and inferior portions. And the only kind of further classification that you need to know is that mid-sagittal or that sagittal plane can be further divided into either mid-sagittal or parasagittal. So mid-sagittal divides it into equal left and right, and parasagittal is basically any other amount. It's an infinite number. And why it's kind of important to keep this into consideration, especially as we look at slides, is that the way that the slide is prepped or the way that it's cut or the way that it's made, it really can dictate what the image is going to look like. And we'll kind of talk about this in chapter 6 a little bit detail, but you just got to keep in mind that sometimes it may not look what you might expect, and it's because you're getting a different plane or you're getting a different cut than you may have in your mind. Okay, so again, it's real cheap and easy chapter. It is there's three main things they want to take away. Okay, the six criteria for standard anatomical position, right? So you should be able to list those six. Know the appropriate directional terms and how to use them comfortably in a sentence. So dorsal, ventral, anterior, posterior, proximal, distal, and then know the anatomical planes.